What happens when you load a homemade FPV plane to its payload limit and try to take off and land on RC unfriendly fields as well? Today I'm putting my 2.2 meter wingspan plane through that test by trying to take off and land with nearly double its own weight through the rough and patchy fields. There's no autopilot, nor safety nets or stabilization features on it, just raw manual mode by the receiver. So will I be able to remain in one piece? Well, let's find out together. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the video.
So I got these homemade from Depron wheel extensions that increase the width and diameter of the total wheel size, so that it'd be more easy to take off and land without it struggling or tipping over potentially. Got the T-motor AT4120, 560 kV motor with the T-motor 18x8 carbon fiber prop. MG90S metal geared servos for the flaperons. Then the Upper Sky X6R with all of its ports in use for BEC and servos, and its antennas externalized for better range. First, let me just get comfortable. And that probably was chopping up a lot of grass first. It's definitely more nose heavy since the HD camera has been placed more forwards. Oh. I definitely have to get used to its new center of gravity. Yeah, this is not it. I really have to come in not as hot as I did. Yeah, that's more like it. All right, time to load it up too, and then see how heavy I could carry things up high, or in general. So we got a pod right here. I'm going to load it up with the battery that I used. So this is what the plane is looking like and dealing with right now. Two of its flight batteries loaded up in these pods, putting the all of weight to about 4.6 plus kilograms. Going to activate my flaperons too. That is plus 4.6 kg all of weight flying around like it is nothing. My throttle input is about like 35-40% maybe. That is flying effortlessly. The only thing I'm having healthy nerves for is the landing, because I don't got the foam wheel extensions on. This is RC unfriendly grass.
it's heavy. And when it tips over, my vertical stabilizer is done for. I'm gonna see how this lands. Please. So that's more than 4.5 kilograms of olive weight flying this nicely.
We now have an additional 600 grams at the front and 600 grams at the rear, with its all-up weight right now being over 6 kilograms. So without any prevention of these sliding out of place, I still added them and then just hope for the best. Plus 6 kg on this airframe. So these are mandatory. Left, right, up, down.
Oh man, that's crazy fast. There's no sign of flex on the wings either. That's amazing. I'm kind of getting sketched out by the battery beeping, but still. Of course, I'm using a bit more throttle, but this is still stable. Still flying like it normally does. Only difference being, I just have to use a little bit more cruise throttle and it's a bit faster, but it still handles the same. That proves that this airframe is quite capable of carrying heavy things. To carry even more weight than this, then I would have to, I think, further increase the wheel extension diameter. This is just 6 kilograms cruising around like it is 2 kilograms. Just look at it. Right. That's crazy. Right, time for the main moment. Please don't tip over at 6 kilograms. Please don't tip over. It's crazy fast too. Well, I'm taking that. You know why? It didn't destroy the vertical stabilizer. Although I have to bend back the motor mount for the so manyth time because it still tipped over. Yeah, I could see the motor mount bent up like that from here. Well, I expected something like that at 6 kilograms though. Yeah, even the very front part, it really digged itself into the ground. No surprise. Yeah, in contrast, this plane still feels the same, but I could ease off my throttle a lot right now. Yeah, that airfoil is way too powerful for me to fly inverted comfortably. That airfoil just acted as a spoiler because it has so much lift. Please come in nicely. Don't tip over.
And in conclusion, conclusion, my 2.2 meter wingspan airplane that was mainly built for touch and go practice is able to carry twice its all-up weight, which opens up the door to different possibilities with it. And my next objective with this aircraft is to install a flight controller, and I'm going for the Matic F411WTE, and it will be installed along with the strobe and beacon lights with a particular method that I have also shared on the channel. The ultimate goal with it is to let it loiter in, return to home, and capture amazing air-to-air footage to be the footage that I use for introducing it in the build video. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.